front squats are a great variation of the dumbbell goblet squat and can be a beneficial alternative if you are struggling to hold a heavier dumbbell. This exercise primarily targets the quadriceps and glutes. To set up this movement, bring the cable pulley all the way to the bottom and use a close grip lat handle attachment. You can perform this movement with your feet completely planted on the ground or with your heels elevated. Elevating your heels is an effective strategy for those who want to maximize quad recruitment. Elevating your heels helps drive your knees further over your toes, which maximize knee flexion. Often people have been incorrectly told that you don't want to have your knees coming over your toes because it's not safe. And this is actually an inaccurate statement. There's little research to suggest that knee injuries will arise from having your knees go over your toes when squatting. Now, if you are recovering from a knee injury, obviously your situation is different, and exercise specificity should be discussed with your physiotherapist. But for those with no history of knee problems, and for those who are wanting to maximize their quad growth, it's not only safe, but necessary. Allowing your knees to go over your toes helps maximize knee flexion, also known as knee bend. This puts you into a more favorable position biomechanically to target the quads, which will maximize growth over time. Feel free to play with both variations to see what works best for you. Start off by getting your feet into the correct position. Whether you're on the ground or with your heels elevated, you want your feet to be about shoulder width apart and have your toes slightly turned out. Then you can bring yourself down into a squat position and grab the handles of the attachment. Then bring the attachment up into a goblet position. To grab the handles, internally rotate your hands so that when you grab the handles, your knuckles are facing each other. Then when you twist your wrists to bring the attachment into a goblet position, you should then have a neutral grip where your palms are facing each other. Stand up from there by extending your knees and your hips at the same time. Once you are fully standing, this is your starting position. To initiate the movement, slowly flex your knees and your hips at the same time while trying to keep the attachment over the midfoot so you can maintain your center of gravity. Come down as far as you comfortably can until you've achieved depth. Depth is typically where your hip joint is lower than your knee joint. However, if your back starts to round and your heels come off the ground, this is an indicator that you are no longer within your active range of motion. So ensure you come as low as you can before any of those types of things happen. Once you've achieved your depth, extend your knees and your hips at the same time to bring yourself back up to the starting position. Ensure that when you stand back up, it's just in a straight line and you aren't arching your lower back or hip thrusting your hips further forward at the top. Simply just focus on standing back up normally and maintaining a neutral spine. For your breathing, focus on breathing in on the way down and then breathing out when you're about midway back up to the top. You don't want to start breathing out when your hips are in a fully bent position, as some athletes, they often can lose tightness in their core and that can cause lower back issues. Instead, focus on holding that air in for just a second and start to breathe it out as you're coming back up to the starting position. And that's the cable front squat.